My name is Courtney Francisco. I'm a reporter at News Channel 4. I witnessed the execution of Clayton Lockett, convicted of murdering 19-year-old Stephanie Neiman. All of the media is in a different building, and then prison officials choose names out of a hat. Who is going to go witness the execution? My name was one of those names, and I loaded up in the van with the other 11 reporters, and we went to the prison grounds. Well, whenever we were in the holding room waiting to go into the execution area, I was talking to other reporters, I was talking to prison officials who have witnessed executions before, and they were telling me, you know, usually they start the drugs and the inmate goes to sleep between 6 and 12 minutes. So that's what I was ready for. And then we sat there, we waited in that room a little bit longer, talking amongst ourselves about what to expect. And then we hear a clanging on the walls. You could hear it through the pipes in the room. It was a steady, and that was the death row inmates banging on their cells, saying their goodbyes to Lockett. At 5 till 6, they said, okay, come on, we're ready for the execution. At that point, prison officials led us into the execution chambers. We sat in a chair, each of us. It was a very tight fit in the execution room. We were very close to the window that separated us from Lockett, and there was a curtain drawn. We couldn't see anything in the execution room at that point. Once you're in the execution room, you're sitting there with a row of 12 reporters. Below you on a lower step is another row of 12 chairs. That's reserved for people that the inmate has requested witness his execution. In this case, Lockett requested that his two attorneys witness his execution. And then the state dignitaries sit on that lower level. Behind us is a window, directly behind us, and we cannot see through that window, through that glass. The family of Stephanie Neiman was behind that glass witnessing the execution as well. We had been waiting in that room for 22 minutes until they raised the curtain. And when they raised the shades, we could see Clayton Lockett lying on the gurney, wrapped in a sheet. His head was sticking out of the sheet, but the rest of him was covered with that sheet. He was awake. He was staring at the ceiling. He did not look left or right. He was staring straight at the ceiling, blinking. He was licking his lips. And that's when the prison officials asked him if he had any last words. And he said no. Simple as that. And that's when the woman prison official said, begin the execution. So at 6:23, when the execution begins, everything seems normal. Lockett is staring at the ceiling. He's blinking like a little fast, like he's nervous, licking his lips. And at 6:30, he starts to quit blinking a little bit, close his eyes, his mouth relaxed. And at that point, the prison officials asked the doctor to check to see if Lockett is unconscious. The doctor got up out of his seat. He walked over to Lockett. He leaned over him very closely to check his vitals. And he said, Mr. Lockett is not unconscious. And Lockett said, I'm not. I could see his lips move. I could hear him say, I'm not. And that was at 6:30. They said, continue pushing the drugs. And then the situation still seemed normal. He calmed down a little bit. They said at 6:33, check to see if he's unconscious again. The doctor gets up, goes over to him, gets very close to him, checks his vitals, and says Mr. Lockett is unconscious. At that point, the prison official gave the go to start the other drugs in the drug cocktail. At 6:33, it's been 10 minutes usually. From what I'm told, executions are normally done by this time. And he's receiving his second round of drugs. And all we know, he is unconscious. That's what we know at this point. But around 6:35, he moved his head like he was adjusting it. And he was showing signs of movement in his mouth. His mouth was twitching. I wasn't sure if that was just a muscle movement, a reaction to the drugs. Maybe this is just normal. And at 6:37, he started, by 6:37, he was moving a lot. He was moving his head. He was adjusting his head, moving it. He was starting to move his body. He was starting to raise his feet. He was mumbling. He was trying to talk, and he was moving. 6:38, he was moving even more. He was almost trying to move off the gurney. He was talking, not words you could understand, but he was mumbling something. At 6:39, he was struggling to breathe. He was struggling to move. He said the word man. We all agreed he said the word man. And at that point, the prison official that is trained to watch his reaction took her eyes off of him and looked out into the witness room. And my gut told me something was not right at that point. And she said, "We're going to go ahead and lower the blinds." And they did. When all this was going on, I did take a moment to look at other people to see how they were reacting. His two attorneys were sitting down here to my left. One of the attorneys was covering his mouth. His chin was shaking. The other attorney was sitting there just blankly watching. The dignitaries from the state, one of them was down like this, not watching. Another one was like this, not watching. That's all you could do. You could either not watch, or you could look at this execution that was clearly not going as planned. The blinds are down. At first, the 12 reporters, the people in front of us, were silent. Clearly, something wasn't going as planned. And then we start looking through our notes, checking our notes against each other's, saying, "Do you have him doing this at this time?" "Yes, yes." We all agreed on that. And then at that point, I said, "Wait a minute. We don't know what's going on the other side of those blinds. Those blinds are down, and we do not know what they're doing to Lockett. We don't know if they're trying to resuscitate him. We don't know what they're doing. And by law, we're supposed to be sitting here as the media witnessing this execution to report back to the public what happened. But we don't know what's happening." When they closed the blinds, we couldn't hear what was going on anymore. They had turned off the speaker system. So again, we kept saying, "We don't know what's going on." And no one was answering our questions. No one from the prison. The prison director, Robert Patton, got out of the room, took a phone call outside of the room. He was gone for several minutes, and then he came back into the room and told us the execution has been halted due to a vein failure. "I'm going to stay this execution, and we're going to stay the execution of Charles Warner for 14 days. And then he left. We went back through the prison, got into a van, drove back to the media holding area, because mind you, there's only 12 seats for the media in this witness room. So the other media members were waiting in that building, waiting for us to get back to tell them what we saw. So when we got back to that room, cameras were waiting on us, and we were telling the other members of the media what we saw. We told them we do not know if he is dead yet. We do not know what happened, because they closed the blinds mid-procedure. They closed the blinds 16 minutes into this procedure. It was supposed to be over after 12 minutes at the most. And they closed the blinds 16 minutes in. So that's what we told the other media members. And then we all waited. We're waiting in that room, and a prison official comes in and tells us that Clayton Lockett was pronounced dead at 7:05 due to a massive heart attack because of the vein failure.
Did anyone ask questions?
We could not ask questions at that point. That was just the messenger. We were all writing our notes. We were all calling in to tell the public what we had just seen, what had just happened. We were talking with our news desks back home saying he was pronounced dead at 7:05 of a massive heart attack due to a vein failure. That's all we know right now. They stopped it mid-procedure. They took down the blinds. We don't know what happened after the first 16 minutes of that execution. And this was just chaos at this point, because this has never happened before in the United States, where they're using this drug cocktail and get this reaction and stop the execution. As reporters, this is what we're here for. This is why we witness these things. This is why the blinds are supposed to be up, because we're supposed to tell the public what happened. It's not that we want to see an execution. We don't want to witness that, but we do it as our duty, and so people at home can make sophisticated decisions about how they feel about it. I don't know if it was humane or not. I'm not Clayton Lockett. I can't answer that. Only he can, and he's dead now. And all I can do is tell the public what I saw and how it played out, and that's what happened.